Good afternoon, Amy. The homeowner believes that these trees are a couple of hundred years old, and that's just one example of the mess that this storm has left behind. Here in Ringe, they had to bring in logging trucks in order to clear some of the roads and get them back open. Now, according to residents, the storm didn't last long, maybe 10 or 15 minutes, but that was enough to cause this damage. While the storm hit different towns at different times, the cells did have some things in common. The thunderstorms were accompanied by swirling wind and torrential rains that at times came down sideways, forcing people to seek shelter.
We're sitting out on the back deck and we could hear the thunder rumbling in from the west. And said, we better get inside, got inside and battened down. And then it just started.
After I watched the trees go down and things got kind of hairy and there was debris flying and branches and all my patio stuff was in the pool and I decided I better go in the garage.
There was like no warning. It just like all of a sudden came and there it was. Bang! I hear this loud. I mean, it was loud. And it scared the bejesus out of me. I think I almost hit the ceiling.
Now, even though in some cases crews worked throughout the night, there were still dangerous situations that remained. While most people do have their power back on, crews are working to continue to restore that power. At last check, there were about 300 customers still in the dark. Reporting live in Ringe, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.